bowl.
You know, if you were really concerned about your future, the last person you'd be getting mated with would be Chrissy. I've told you that before. She's nothing but trouble. But you should know that.
She's changed.
Oh, the only way she's going to change is from rotten to worse.
You're wrong, Bea. She's changing because of a baby. She really wants it. She wants to get out of this place and stay out.
Did she pull the wool over your eyes? She is nothing but a little bitch. She always was and she always will be.
I'd like to make up my own mind about that, thank you, Bea.
On your own head, be it, then.
Wait till you hear what I've got to tell you.
Who cares?
I heard Vera talking. Want to know what they're looking for?
What?
Oh, of course, if some people aren't interested, I could,
Come on, Chrissy, what are they looking for?
A key.
A key?
Hmm.
What sort of key?
To the security gates. You see, they reckon we must have been able to get through the gates to get Vera's radio back to the staff room.
Oh.
There you are, you silly little nit. I told you not to trust that radio to the social worker.
Keep his word. He didn't dob me in.
But we've put up all this searching because of him.
There's nothing we can do about that now.
Oh, isn't there? Well, we'll see. If he started it, he can stop it. I'll just have to have a little word with him, won't I?
Is all this noise really necessary, Miss Ray?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Mueller.
I don't see how you could possibly concentrate with that going on.
Oh, yes, I can. It helps. Gets real lonely in here without the tranny.
Really? You surprise me. The number of times young Burns has popped in to speak to you, I didn't think you had enough time to get lonely.
Well, he just came back to lend me his tranny.
Yeah, well, as I said, I don't see how it can be anything but a distraction. Now, let's have a look at some of your work, shall we? Just as I thought. Here's a parcel without any postcode on it. You know, it's essential to use the postcode. You've been told that.
Well, I must have missed it.
Yes, obviously. Let me tell you something, young lady. You'll stand a far better chance of keeping your job if you'd concentrate on the work instead of mooning about over some young delivery driver.
Yes, Mr. Mueller.
Thanks, Sterling.
Good afternoon.
Hey, Mr. Jackson. Well, what's happening today?
Well, I've just come on duty, but I gather there's some sort of search going on.
Search for what?
Well, I haven't found out the details yet. Something must be missing, I suppose.
Never ends, does it?
Oh, Bea Smith wants to see you.
Oh, that's good, because I want to see her too. Could you bring her to my office in about 15 minutes?
Right.
Oh, and Meg, I hope you'll forgive me for snapping at you yesterday.
Sure.
Did you weren't here last night? We had some whiskey that Billy pinned from his old man. That and a couple of joints, old boy.
Sounds great. You sure the other people won't mind me camping here for a few days?
Of course they won't. Bill and I've got one room and Carl and Noel's got the other. So you'll have to rough it in here for a few days.
That's fine.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Alison, Tony wants to stay with us for a few days.
Yeah, sure. Bad scene at home, eh?
Yeah, the old man kept hassling me, so I cleared out.
Good idea. The sooner you get him off your back, the better. The only time I ever go home is when I need some bread.
And a pinch of bottle of whiskey. Tony's applying for an apprenticeship with BHP.
Yeah, I want to get a job working in the mines. I shouldn't be here too long.
No problem. Sally, I got much dope left.
Only these.
Is that all?
Well, we went through a lot last night, don't forget. Anyway, Sharon's coming around later with another deal. I hope someone's got some bread for her.
Not me.
Oh, hell, she won't leave the stuff if we can't pay her for it.
Well, I've got a little bit of money in the bank. You can borrow some of that. I won't be needing it for a while.
Oh, great. Can you get it out today?
Yeah, I've got an interview with BHP this afternoon. I can go to the bank on the way.
Well, I think you're going to fit in real well here, mate.
Of course he will.
Before long, they'll be taking everything that isn't nailed down.
Not if we find that key, though, won't.
Where else is there to look?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to rest until we find the damn thing.
Yes. Well, if we don't, we could have the prisoners letting themselves out of the place. That'd make us a laughing stock, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it's a wonder we aren't already. The security around this place just isn't tight enough.
Why don't you make that point to Mrs. Davidson?
She knows how I feel.
Doesn't influence her much, though, does it?
B. Smith to see you?
No, thank you, Mrs. Jackson.
Call me when she's ready to go back, will you?
Well, how are you, B?
No better for your asking. I suppose you're really pleased with yourself.
Yeah, what do you mean by that?
All we've been put through because of you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The search. Not only the cells, but us. It's bloody disgusting having screws running their hands all over your body. It's enough to make your stomach turn.
You can't blame me for that.
It was you that returned the radio to the staff room, wasn't it?
Yes, but I still don't see what that's got.
Oh, Gordon, I bet he's got a degree from some university and everything. The screws reckon one of us returned it. Now, to do that, we would have to have a key to the security gates, and that's what they're looking for right now, thanks to you.
I see.
And we're bloody annoyed about it.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't intend to do anything to harm anyone.
Oh, isn't that terrific? Everything we've managed to smuggle in or pinch been taken by the screws.
Is this search still going on?
From what I've heard, they're not going to stop until they pull the place apart and find it. But they're not going to, are they? We know that, because it doesn't exist. So we're going to have to put up with a lot of inconvenience for nothing.
Not if I can put a stop to it.
Oh, yeah, how?
By telling Mrs. Davidson the truth, that I returned the radio to the staff room.
And that a Dob Rosin.
I don't have to say where I got it from.
You all right? That might work. You give it a go?
All right, I will. On one condition.
What do you mean, one condition? You started. This is up to you to stop.
I will. I said I will. If you help me to get the women involved in my latest project.
Oh, Gord, not another bright idea. How do we know we can trust you?
Well, I didn't lag on Chrissy Latham when she had a key, did I? And I did help to get Rosie out of the pound.
Yeah.
Look, B, the women need something that they can get involved in. Take Rosie, for example. She needs something to occupy her mind. She's an intelligent woman. She should be given the opportunity to put that intelligence to some use. And you too, for that matter.
Me? I'm no brain.
Oh, come on. You've got more brains than half the screws here put together.
You're not too stupid yourself. All right. I'll talk to the woman. You talk to the governor.
It's a deal.
This had better not be a con.
Be, would I con you?
Well, it's got me tossed. I don't mind admitting it.
They must have got rid of it somehow. Perhaps down the toilet, something like that.
We can hardly dig up the drains. Do you really think that's what happened?
Well, we can't be sure. That's the trouble.
And it was a very thorough search.
Very.
A key's such a small thing. It's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Well, even so, every officer knew how important it was. I don't think one of us would have missed it.
Come in.
Mrs. Davidson, could I see you for a moment, please?
We're in the middle of discussing a problem, Mr. Reed.
I may have the solution to your problem, if it's to do with the radio that was returned to the staff room.
Yes, it is. Come in and close the door, please.
Do you know something about this?
Yes, I'm afraid I'm the person responsible.
What do you mean?
I'd be very interested to hear your information, Mr. Reed.
One of the women gave me the radio. She explained that it had been taken from the staff room, so I simply returned it.
Who gave it to you?
I'm not at liberty to say.
That's not good enough.
No, it certainly is not. I don't think you realize the seriousness of the matter, Mr. Reed. To have taken the radio, the prisoner concerned would have to have a key to the security gates.
There's no key.
Then how did she get the radio in the first place?
Lizzie Birdsworth took it. I gather she'd been to see you and you let her leave unaccompanied.
That's true. Lizzie did have an opportunity to take the radio.
Then all our effort has been for nothing.
It would appear so. It's a great pity you didn't inform us earlier.
Well, I wasn't here this morning, so I didn't know what was going on.
Yes, well, thank you for the information, Mr. Reed.
Oh, I would like to see you on another matter when you have time.
Perhaps tomorrow.
Fine.